given openings and closings, dilations, erosions, this hit or miss transform that I was talking about that pulls out the shape, you can then do further things. Okay, here's a list of them: boundary, region, extracting, connecting components, convex hull, thinning, skeletons, pruning. I'm just going to talk about two, and I'm really going to just talk about one in detail, not even detail, one slide's worth, and then thinning I'll just mention. Okay, so sometimes you'd like to extract the boundary. Well, actually, that's very easy to do. What I can do is I can take an object. If A plus B is the dilation, A minus B is the erosion, I can get the boundary by just taking the object and subtracting out the eroded version of it. Here they talk about B being a 3x3 square. It could be whatever size square. I'm going to take the binary pixels, and I'm going to remove any of the ones that survive the erosion process. All right? So you want to do that, and voila, this is what you get. And you realize what's happening here, of course, is here's our original binary image. And when I erode, the contour moves in by a certain amount. And if it's 3x3 by at least 1.5, 2 pixels. So what that'll do is if I subtract what's inside the red from the whole thing, I end up with just this boundary. So it's just a trivial operation, right? I take the image, erode it, and then subtract those pixels. When I subtract, I mean remove those pixels from the original. And that's how you do boundaries. There's another operation called thinning. You'll notice this operator here, this is this hit or miss operator. What matters is you take your original picture and you've got these different structuring elements, and essentially you keep eating away at your picture using that structuring, those structuring elements, and you would go from this filled in picture like this, you would end up with something that's just like this, or it's a 1 pixel wide thin band, right, when you keep doing the thinning, and that can be used for finding skeletons. There used to be a lot of thought about using skeletons for a variety of shape representations when we were doing models, and people still use it, and that's why I mention it. But I'm not going to talk any more about it. It's just thinning and thickening. And in fact, the thickening is just the inverse of that. So here you have this original thing, and then you're growing it out till you get out towards the boundary of some sort. Again, I'm not going to worry too much about the details.